And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Dale died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. And on the day of his baptism, Dale was clothed with the garment of salvation. The cross we have brought here today was carried by the Lord Jesus in the hour of his suffering. We place it now on this casket as a sign of our hope for Dale. Lord Jesus Christ, you loved us unto death. Let this cross be a sign of your love for Dale, for Millie, for all of their family who have gathered here today.
Eternal God, who made the union of man and woman the sign of the body. life on earth, find a lasting reward in heaven. Look kindly on many family as now they turn to your compassionate love. Strengthen their faith and lighten their hearts. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated now for the reading of the Sacred Scripture.
The first reading is a reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought as affliction, and their going forth from us, utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men, indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them. And as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose, beside restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
The second reading is a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Not supposed to happen this way, is it? These are tough times, very tough times. I understand, Judy, that you wanted Mom anointed sometime today, obviously, before going back and the shutdown and that kind of thing. Providentially, actually, I've called Brenda, Doug and Karen know, that I'm going to go and anoint Grace after the funeral today. I set that up with her, so that I thought, rather, as you probably can tell, that the bishop doesn't want us to be in large gatherings in small places or whatever. So if you don't mind, before our final commendation here, as long as all of you are present, I would like to anoint Millie, okay? So that's done and we can do it in the church here, and that would be, we will add that. And also I think she would be very pleased at the fact that she's with Dale. I was actually glad that you changed the first reading today. Ecclesiastes is a nice reading. But if you know the reading, where that reading comes from, it was made into a song, and we all know it in memory. There's a time for to be born, and a time to die, a time to reap, and a time to sow, and all of those kinds of things. But it really talks about the futility of life, and that's kind of what we feel. But in this first reading from the Book of Wisdom, which we heard, this is very important for us to hear. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. Sometimes we don't know what words mean until we experience them. And literally, we are in a time going through a lot of torment, a lot of destruction. In view of the foolish, they seem to be dead. They're passing away, utter destruction, but they're in peace. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them. As sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples. I think as a priest, as a pastor, having to deal with so many people, so many families like this, one thing that has come to my own mind is that for so much of our own life in the world in which we live today, we thought we had everything under control. We thought we could fix everything. And all of a sudden we find ourselves
being vulnerable. And even in death, people live to be a long age. I mean, otherwise, 87 years old, we'd be celebrating his death if he died of a heart attack. 87 years old, it's a long time. 66 years with one wife. Those are beautiful, beautiful things. And we have to remember that and to celebrate that, because that's the reality of their life. But this moment is really, even in the hardship, and see that in Millie now, she knows, and yet, this in many respects was something that, maybe not in this circumstance, they were always prepared for. I know that as their pastor. For the years that I knew them and when they were so frequently here, they lived off of the Holy Eucharist. Every day. Every day, not just on weekends and Sundays, but they so often were here. If things were the same, they would have been here an hour earlier for the adoration of the Blessed Sacrament and benediction. And so we have to look at that is the reality of their life. But we, who kind of live in a more faithless age, that we don't know what to do when things like this happen and we aren't in control. I was telling the kids this morning at the morning mass, explaining the fact, it doesn't really seem like we're in Christmas, does it? Preparing for it, just a few weeks away. There's something missing, right? There's something missing, that joy and that happiness or whatever, because this, all of this looms over us. But I said to them, you know, this is the way it was at the first Christmas. We've just celebrated parties for 2,000 years. But at the first Christmas, there was a darkness in the world. There was a darkness in life. And for centuries and centuries, they longed and waited for the light to come, for the glory of the people of Israel. The light that shone in the darkness, that was what the readings were this morning. And as we light this Advent wreath, it is to indicate to us that longing. So we should think about that. And what are we longing for? Well, 2,000 years ago, they were waiting for a Savior. And he came. But we are too. We want to be saved from this, all of this. But we're given that important instruction within our own faith. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have not told you so? That I am going to prepare a place for you. And that is what gives us hope, even in the midst of all of this, that your dad and mom, your grandma and grandpa have lived their whole life knowing that in this earth, and especially knowing how they felt all about you and how you feel about them, of what they have meant to you throughout their life, and their grandchildren and their great-grandchildren. But to know that this isn't heaven. This isn't the final place. This isn't the final end. It would be tragic, wouldn't it, if this is what life was all about, was this. This life is in readiness, in preparation for something more. For something more. The place that God has prepared for us. And so, Dale and Millie living their whole life, meeting one another, falling in love with one another, getting married, having this wonderful family, and of living out a promise that they made to one another, but most importantly, a promise that they made to God. When they stood at this altar and they promised that they would love each other in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, all the days of their life. And all of you who are married know that doing that every day is not easy. It takes work to love each other in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. And Jesus is saying that I am going to prepare a place for you, which he did. And Thomas says, Master, we don't know where you're going. Show us the way. And Jesus says to them, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father. No one gets to heaven. No one inherits the kingdom except through me. Follow me. So each of us try to do that in our own life of faith. But I'll tell you what. You have something better. Not just a book called the Bible. Not just a faith and our profession of faith. But you have Dale and Millie. If you want to know the way, ask them. Ask them. They know the way. And so as we gather in this very crazy time, and as I said to our children, I said, you know, even the Christmas and the gifts and the lights, all of those things that used to make us feel joyful and happy or whatever, we're trying. But even in all of those things will never really make us joyful and happy unless we know what the reason for the season is. And maybe this Christmas time, in our own conscience and our own heart, we will see it for the first time, that it is Jesus who is the reason for the season. We get our own hearts, our minds, our children, our world on Christ, who came 2,000 years ago, but who promised he would remain with us forever. And that's the heart of it. I'm so glad that I'm going to be able to give, hopefully, Millie communion today, which she hasn't received, Dale hasn't received for ages. And I know that that was a big concern, because that was at the heart of their life. But I will tell you this, that even despite all of that, they have a Eucharistic heart. The reason why they came here every day was because they were with Jesus. Body, blood, soul, and divinity. He promised us that when he left this earth, that he would remain with us as we will celebrate at Mass. This is my body, this is my blood given for you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood will have eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. And so Dale and that Eucharistic heart, and Millie, who understood that. And so Jesus wasn't our Savior 2,000 years ago. Jesus is our Savior today. We need to long for him as they longed for all of those ages before. And so today, as we celebrate this Mass of Christian burial for Dale, it is not the end. It's the beginning. I want you to listen very carefully to the words of the preface just before the Eucharistic prayer. For those who are faithful, life has changed. It hasn't ended. For those who are faithful, life has changed and not ended. I oftentimes refer to this, and we should know this in our own heart to build us in faith. Take a look at the rest of all of God's creation, apart from human beings. All life, do they do this? Do they mourn? Do they have funerals? Do they bring people to, do they bring their their animal friends to church? No. They live and they die. That's the nature of their life. Why are we here? There's two things that I know about those old folks. Number one, they want to be with each other and they want to be with their families, and that's the killer of what happened. But the third thing, they want to go back to their church. And thank God that we're here today to be able to be in this church and to give Dale the proper honor and respect and the blessing. Their passing away was thought an affliction. They're going away, going forth from us, utter destruction, but they are in peace. And let me tell you, let me know, I think I mentioned to some of the family members as we had the viewing today, that guy better be praying for us, not we just praying for him. Huh? And we're not separated from each other if we have faith. If our faith is strong, that we will always be together. That's what communion means. Let us enjoy that communion that we share not only with Dale and Millie, but also share with our Lord Jesus Christ, as he promises that in his own passion and death and resurrection, that he will bring us to the place that has been prepared for us, where there will be no more sorrow, no more sickness, none of this, but only joy and peace and eternal light in Christ. Please stand now as we offer our prayers and petitions. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all of his people, living and dead. For Dale, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, may he now be admitted to the company of the saints. We pray to the Lord. For Dale, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord. For our deceased relatives and friends and all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord. For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord. For the family and friends of Dale, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend, Lazarus, we pray to the Lord. And for all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. For we ask this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated now as I prepare the altar for the Holy Eucharist.
Please stand. And pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Dale, we beseech your mercy, that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find now in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection is dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Prayer. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Dale, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Ask those who will be coming to Holy Communion to kneel if possible, and the others may be seated. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, Dale may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. I'd ask you to please be seated. Laurie, do you want to bring Millie forward? Lord God, you have said through your apostle James, are there people sick among you? Let them send for the priests of the church, and let the priests pray over them, anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord. The prayer of faith will save the sick persons, and the Lord will raise them up. And if they have committed any sins, their sins will be forgiven them. Lord, we have gathered here in your name, and we ask you to be among us, to watch over Millie. We ask this with confidence, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Millie, through this holy anointing, may the Lord in his love and mercy help you with the grace of the Holy Spirit, and may the Lord, who frees you from your sins, save you and raise you up. And now let us pray together as our Lord has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. God of mercy, look kindly on your servant Millie, who has grown weak under the years, and in this holy anointing she asks for strength in body and soul. Fill her with the strength of your Holy Spirit. Keep her firm in faith and serene in hope, so that she may give us all an example of patience and joyfully witness to the power of your love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. And may the Lord bless and keep you. May the Lord let his face shine upon you and give you his peace, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. There, that's fine. We come now to the final commendation and farewell, but beforehand, just to, again, I want to just express my love and admiration of your family, and especially knowing how difficult it has been during these times of wanting to do so much for them and with them, and I know that they appreciate it all, and so God bless you. And so now we come to the final commendation and farewell. Please stand. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Dale, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we will see him again and enjoy his love and friendship. Although we may disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ, as we listen now to the song of farewell. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend Dale in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon him in his life, especially with his wife and family. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother Dale forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In peace now, let us take Dale to his place of rest.